My name is Erin Hamilton, and I am the Year 3 Health and Physical Education, or HPE, coordinator. This evening I'm going to run through why HPE is important for your child's development, including their fundamental motor skills, where HPE fits within the curriculum, and also our approaches to teaching and learning in HPE. So I guess I'll start off with what is HPE, and why is it important to your child's learning and development? HPE builds a foundation for your child to make healthy life choices and include regular physical activity into their lives. So a well-organized and structured HPE program will positively benefit your child both physically and emotionally. Health looks at safety, positive interactions, communication, and contributing to an active community. And the physical education program has been designed to engage children in physical activity and foster a positive relationship with movement and physical activity. So the Australian curriculum engages children in this learning through participation in movement, and this is through different forms of movement and their benefits. Fundamental motor skills like jump, catch and overhand throw lay the foundation for developing common sport and movement skills, and if proper fundamental motor skills are not developed, then your child will probably be less likely to learn the associated sport and movement skills. I'll just show you this table. This is a fundamental motor skill table. It goes from prep to year 5. And it's an example of when we introduce fundamental motor skills and also the progression of learning these skills within the curriculum. So let's have a little just down here at the overhand throw, for example. We introduce this skill in year 1. And over the next 2 years, we'll work with your child to ensure that they meet the must outcome, which is expected by year 4. So the overhand throw is a skill which is required for most sports, really. If we think about cricket, volleyball, and tennis. And so in year 2, it was expected that your child could demonstrate 2 of the critical elements of the overhand throw. So as you can see here, there's the ready position, the side target, arm back, stop, rotate, and follow through. And in year 3, they should progress to 3 of the critical elements so that by year 4, they'll have the ability to master the overhand throw with accuracy. It is important, however, to note that we do value proper instruction over accuracy. So, for example, a cricket player who lands on the wrong foot and struggles to throw the ball from the field could have been the primary age child that wasn't taught to lengthen their arm when throwing. So habits learnt in the early years do become lasting motor skills in later life. So when children become confident with fundamental motor skills, they view themselves as competent, socially successful, and they also develop a positive relationship with PE, which prepares them for living a healthy and rewarding lifestyle. Right. Our Year 3 HPE program is a carefully designed program, and it aims to meet the developmental outcomes from the Australian curriculum, HPE. And this is categorised into 2 strands, personal, social and community health and movement, and also physical activity. So each strand, as you can see here, explains their focus, so the focus areas, and then the outside is the structure of the Australian curriculum and where that fits. So the focus areas of our Year 3 HPE curriculum will ensure that educators provide appropriate content relating to the developmental age of your children. So, moreover, the destination we want for your child is obviously to be physically educated. So we plan the journey accordingly, and we look at things such as where are we going? So what's the scope and sequence? When we arrive, what is our unit of inquiry? How will we arrive? What resources do we need? And what does it look like when we have arrived? So how do we deliver and assess this learning with the children? It's important to note that our HPE lessons are designed so that we can modify them for children of all abilities, and that is that they can be made easier or more complex. And we achieve this by adopting a strength-based approach to learning, meaning that although each child has differing abilities and access to resources, we build the capacity for each of them to make healthy, safe, and active lifelong choices. So the strength-based approach in the curriculum does work with children to develop positive relationships with HPE and believes that they have the capacity to learn and grow for success. And this is based off the principles that each child is capable of being healthy and confident, can improve improve their health and well-being through participation in physical activity, and also has the capacity to engage in an active community. So I guess to sum it up, our priority in HPE is to deliver age-appropriate opportunities for children to engage and apply knowledge of necessary skills that will support them with their health, well-being, and involvement in physical activity. We'll achieve this by following the guide of the Australian curriculum and adopting the strength-based approach to ensure that no child is left behind. And through HPE programs, your child will be able to develop holistically by having opportunities to engage in challenging environments. To learn, and engaging.